ultimately translates to war. So when the scripture speaks about the strife of tongues, again, those tongues represent the power that Esau has to control the narrative through his legislations and laws, which are on display through his media, which are all set up in effort to wage war against the children of Israel. Now, when you stroll down here to the Strong's definitions for this word strife, it takes you to the word adversary. Adversary. Which for those of us in the know, we understand that this word adversary goes back to the Hebrew word Satan, which translates to Satan, which would be none other than that old serpent, the devil and Satan, the so-called white man himself. So the warning that emanates from the Holy Scriptures has nothing to do with Satan in the mythical sense. You know, some guy in a red spandex suit with a pointed tail and a set of horns, wielding a triton in his hand and waiting to possess and torment your soul forever and ever. No, the prophets was raised up and sent forth to warn you of your arch enemy and nemesis, which would be none other than Esau, the so-called white man. See? Which brings me right here to the book of Psalms, the 74th chapter. And starting at the 7th verse, it says, they have cast fire into thy sanctuary. They have defiled by casting down the dwelling place of thy name to the ground. They said in their hearts, let us destroy them together. They have burned up all the synagogues of the Most High in the land. Yeah, and what we read in here is pretty much concerning the falling away of Israel, which started with us being driven out of our land and scattered into the four winds, and ultimately being discontinued from our heritage, in which the current state of the so-called Negro, Latino, and Native American serves as a witness, if you will, to that epic fall. See? Verse 9, we see not our signs. We see not our signs. There is no more any prophet, neither is there among us any that knoweth how long. Yeah, let's read this again. It says, we see not.